For equipment, I'll be using a pair of wall clippers. I guess that's a pair, it's only one. A set of clippers by Wall. I'll put a link in the description. I'm gonna use some Wall hair clipper blade oil to keep it oiled up so it lasts a long time. Yeah, that's it pretty much. I'm not gonna use a comb or scissors. This is gonna be straight up clippers. Hopefully I won't even have to use any guards. This is going to be a fade with the most adventurous kind you can have. No guard. I'm just going to use this adjuster on the side to adjust the blade a little bit. But in general, we're just going to trust our instincts. We're going to keep a solid, stiff wrist and just get upward strokes with the arm. Use the side of the head as a guide to go straight up, and then when the head starts to curve towards the top, just keep it going straight. You stay consistent and smooth, and you don't do anything too extreme, you should be okay. You're gonna need another mirror for the back of your head if you're gonna cut your hair yourself. If you don't do anything too extreme, if it all goes right, you don't have to go to last resort, which is to chop it all off to save your cut. All right, let's do it. Clipper, oil. Gonna extend the blades, just run it across, turn it on, allow it to get in, adjust the blade up and down, should be on there real smooth, and you're good to go. Start off the blade high setting, go to town. Notice that my hair is a little too long, doesn't have the resistance to be able to use the no guard all the way up. So I'm going to do the half guard, which would be the red right here, to go up with it, get the hair a little shorter, a little more resistant, and then the no guard blade should be able to catch it and do a good job. Remember, this is a high fade, so if we're going up really high, this is going to be pretty much no guard all the way across. Don't worry about that.
Let's rewrite it. My pants fitting, so you better tie your pants.
on the lowest setting and get a little bit underneath his back, fade it up a little bit more. Start wide, which is kind of taking away slowly but surely. Give it a final once over. Make sure the hair that's sticking around, the loose hair, is not deceiving the way your cut actually looks. Now mine, not perfect. I'm an amateur. And I'm always having to deal with this bump on the right side of my head. Bulges out, whereas the left side kind of goes straight up. It's a different thing you gotta deal with. Sometimes you gotta adjust your cut because it'll look odd. Because that difference there. Everybody's got a different head, everybody's got a different hair. Some people, you got the crown in the back, some people got two crowns, some people got cowlick up front. You got all sorts of different things you deal with. You dealing with hair. Let's see what this one looks like. Well, it's a little raggedy back there in the back. I'm gonna deal with it, I'm gonna live with it. It's been hard just to get a hold of it. I don't know, there, getting a little longer there. And it's a self-cut. But it'll grow out quickly. I don't think it'll be very noticeable. It can also be where my head was pressed down. I just woke up, so. Could just be some of that that might even out once you wash it. And put some styling gel in or whatever. That's how you do it. The high fade, so to speak, it fades up the side of your head. You kind of just use your head as the fade by drawing a straight line up your head. Alright, fresh out of the shower, you'll see some things happen. Some hairs will pop out that you didn't get. What you can do if you want, since you've got a nice line across your head, you can take scissors. Just kind of clean it up. Oh, that was a little deep. Amateur here. But just kind of clean up, straighten the line a little bit. It'll help. You see, like, if I were to flatten my hair, this is going to end up sticking up. These hairs that are there and these stick out a little bit. This is not the way you want to rock this look. While this is still growing out, you're going to want to push your hair towards the center. You could probably leave it dry, and so long as it's stuck towards the center, you'd be fine. It's a case of my hair anyway. But when it comes to styling, I'm going to use this Suave Men Professional Styling Paste. It's like somewhere between wax and gel. It's not bad. White. Got a decent smell, not real overpowering or anything. Just take a little bit, actually it might even be too much, because it'll spread real well in your hands. I just spread it around. Wow, yeah, that was too much. For this amount of hair, this is probably gonna overpower it, but that's all right, it'll work out. You probably wanna have it a little wet when you start with it, but just work it in there, and work it in there real good, because it's white and it's thick. So if you don't, if you don't get it real good, it will end up showing up somewhere. So my initial style, that's not looking too bad. But you can do all sorts of things. You can take it to one side if you're feeling real extreme. Well, that's not my natural side to do that on. Take it to the other. You can do something in the center. If you like that, You put enough of it in there, you can take it back. Not my favorite. Or you kind of alternate it. And that's what I think I'm gonna go with. What do you think? It's pretty versatile style. It's not real great dry and sticking out. Very casual, run out of the bed and go kind of style. But you can put a little water in it or just put a little styling paste, even gel. You can use whatever you want. And it's got a decent look. It's clean and fresh on the sides, and you've got a little length on the top to play with. If you enjoyed this video, give it a like, give it a thumbs up, share it if you want to. No big deal. Have a great day, and I'll see you next time.
Hey, come on in. It's just not happening.
Stop. Hey, guys, we gotta talk about this. This is just not happening for me. Let's rewrite it.